Hi everybody, in this video we are going to learn about ionization of water. Water formula we know, that is H2O. In this video we are going to study the ionization of water, that is what. And here see ionization of water, here water they are taking H2O. Initially what we studied, anything, any substance, acid or base, acid or base or salt, it can undergo ionization only in the presence of water in aqueous medium according to Arrhenius. So, and now this is the case of water. Water also can undergo ionization in the presence of water generally. So here both are water molecule, this is H2O, this is also H2O. In between the two water molecule there is a ionization, that is why this ionization is called as autoionization. Autoionization, both are water molecule. Here in these two water molecule, one water molecule is donating this H plus, other water molecule accepting that H plus, accepting that H plus by donating electron pair. So which can donate electron pair, that is a base. Which can donate a proton is called acid. So based on this, what happened, this water molecule losing of H plus losing, so that OH minus remaining, this water molecule accepting that H plus, so H3O plus forming, this is hydronium ion. What this is called as, this is hydronium ion. And some books you can see this hydronium ion we can represent with the H plus also in some books. Here as we studied in Brønsted Lowry theory, this acid the correspondingly will be, there is a base, these two acid 1 and base 1 are conjugate acid base pair. Similarly base 2 and similarly what I can say similarly base 2 and acid 2, these two are conjugate acid base pair. Always remember, conjugate acid base pairs are differ by one proton. In this manner you can remember, in the above ionization one water molecule act as an acid, this water molecule acting as a acid, while other water molecule act as a base. This water molecule acting like a base because it is accepting, this is accepting proton, it is losing proton, so that it is acting like acid, it is acting like a base. In between the two water molecule it is undergoing ionization, is undergoing, so that it is auto ionization. Okay, and here the dissociation constant for the above ionization given by what we studied, this is the thing. Dissociation constant means it's like a equilibrium constant only. What is that? Products, what we can write here, products concentrations by this reactants concentration. Now we are going to write like that only. See, so K, H3O plus, these two are products. This is a H2O concentration and H2O, this is a reactant. This is like an equilibrium constant, but here we are talking, this we are giving a name as a dissociation constant. Now here H2 is a pure liquid. For pure liquids and all, the concentration square bracket H2O, H2O concentration here in the square bracket H2O denoting means, that is the meaning of concentration of H2O. For pure liquids the concentration considered as a 1. Here 2 H2O concentration and H2O concentration, here H2O square, that 1 into 1 coming as a 1 only. Here now this is going this side, no, this is going this side, so K becomes KW, and this is the product, hydronium ion into OH minus ion. This hydronium ion, some books H3O plus, some books you may study as H plus ion, both are correct only. Here H plus and OH minus, proton and a hydroxyl ion. That product is called as KW. This is called as ionic product. KW is called as ionic product. This is very important. Ionic product. This is constant for a water where at a particular temperature. Temperature very very important. At 25 degrees only this ionization possible. These concentrations are existing. So that this product is going to existing. So therefore ionic product of water at 25 degrees centigrade is KW is equal to hydronium ion concentration and hydroxyl ion H3O plus into OH minus ion concentrations. Here based on some experimentally they are finding the concentration of hydronium ion and OH minus, both are equal concentration, that is equal to 10 power minus 7. The 10 power minus 7 you are writing here. H3O plus also 10 power minus 7 and OH minus also 10 power minus. This value is a absolutely experimental value. Experimental value you are writing here. So 10 power minus 7 into 10 power minus 10 power minus 14. Hereafter, what you have to feed in your mind? KW is equal to 10 power minus 14. Fix in your mind this one. Ionic product of water is equal to 10 power minus 14. And also KW is equal to H3O plus hydronium ion concentration into OH minus ion concentration. And also you can say, what you can say? Some books H plus hydronium ion concentration is equal ionic product is equal to H plus concentration into OH minus concentration. All these are correct. What are the correct? This is the formula, the second one, and this is the third one. So you have to remember all these things. This will come in the numerical problems. See, like all equilibrium constant, KW is a constant at a particular temperature. Whatever the KW ionic product we are going to study, it is at a particular temperature. Generally our temperature will be 25 degrees centigrade. So all this chapter, throughout the chapter, KW value we are going to use as a 10 power minus 14, because 25 degrees is our normal temperature. In case temperature changes means here KW value changes. Why? What is the reaction we studied? H2O plus H2O gives, what is coming? H3O plus and plus OH minus. This is at 25 degrees centigrade. This much amount of H3O plus coming, this much amount of OH minus coming. If you are increasing temperature increase means, temperature increases means what happened here? Temperature increases means this value, the amount of H3O plus ions, hydronium ions can increase, OH minus ions also increase. So what is KW? KW means concentration of H3O plus ions into concentration of OH minus ions. Both the values increase means obviously KW value also increases. When temperature increases, KW value increases. Whatever the value we are studying, this one, KW is equal to 10 power minus 14. It is only at 25 degrees centigrade, which is our room temperature generally. So that why I am talking about this slide means only to explain about temperature. Temperature changes means KW value changes. In our chapter, we are going to maintain KW is equal to 10 power minus 14 because our atmospheric temperature generally 25 degrees centigrade. That is why we are maintaining. Dissociation of water is endothermic because we have to give temperature. It is taking temperature, so that it is endothermic. The same point only, with increasing in temperature, the concentration of H3O plus and OH minus ions increases. Hence, the product also increases. These two increases. What I can say? These two increases. This KW also increases. That's it. And next one is, and based on this, H3O plus ions refers hydronium ion, that is refer for acidic nature. OH minus ions refers for basic nature. We know that OH minus ion refers for which nature? Basic nature. Here in a solution, concentration of hydronium is more greater than OH minus, that is acidic. In a solution, concentration of hydronium is less than OH minus. Here OH minus ions is more, at the time it is a basic. Both are equal means that will be a neutral. Some books what you can see is in the place of hydronium ion you can see. For acidic solution you can say as a H plus ion concentration is greater than OH minus ion concentration. Similar way, for basic solution, H plus ion concentration is less than OH minus ion concentration. In some books you can say for neutral solution, H plus ion concentration is equal to OH minus ion concentration. This is also correct only. This is what our study regarding ionization of water. So observe the video carefully. Watch the video carefully. Thank you.